Hello, my name is Cullen Taniguchi. I'm an assistant professor of radiation oncology at MD Anderson Cancer Center. I'm very happy to discuss our paper, Mitochondrial Fusion Exploits the Therapeutic Vulnerability of Pancreatic Cancer. Pancreatic cancer is the third leading cause of cancer-related death currently, and is projected to be the second leading cause of cancer-related death. Pancreatic cancer grows quickly and spreads aggressively, and this is due in part to its reliance on mitochondrial metabolism. Not surprisingly, several prominent groups have verified that mitochondrial metabolism plays a prominent role in its pathobiology and its treatment resistance. The mitochondria generate energy in the cell. And when most people think about mitochondria, they think of a stylized mitochondria, such as shown here in this slide, which is a bean-shaped organelle structure. However, when we looked at mitochondria in real cells, they are anything but a static bean. They are highly dynamic organelles that often fuse together to form long tubular structures, as shown here in yellow using time-lapsed confocal microscopy. Actin filaments are purple and the nucleus is blue, and we can see each mitochondria is highly moving and is also a very long structure. We wondered what pancreatic cancer and normal pancreas mitochondria look like. First, we looked at normal pancreatic ductal cells. And using a dye called MitoTracker Red, we confirmed that normal tissues have these long, elongated mitochondria. These were further confirmed by using high-resolution electron microscopy, as you can see in the lower panel. When we looked at pancreatic cancer cells, however, the mitochondria were very abnormal. They were small and highly fragmented, as again, you can see here using the MitoTracker dye in the upper panel and using electron microscopy in the lower panel. We want to confirm that this was the case in as many human cases as we could see. And indeed, when we looked at our cell line collection here at MD Anderson, nearly all of the pancreatic cancer lines derived from patient tumors exhibited this abnormal fragmentation. Recent studies have shown that this fragmentation likely arises from a KRAS mutation that commonly occurs in pancreatic cancer. So based on this fact that abnormal mitochondria are often seen in pancreatic cancer, we wondered if we attacked that aspect of mitochondrial biology, whether it could serve as a therapeutic target. And that is the basis of this paper. And indeed, we find that if we normalize the tiny fragmented mitochondria in pancreatic cancer and force them to form tubular structures, that pancreatic cancer energy homeostasis is altered and it acts in a strongly tumor-suppressive manner.
Hi, my name is Nick Nguyen, and I'm one of the authors on our paper that explores how mitochondrial morphology can be used as a therapeutic target against pancreatic cancer. So this interplay between mitochondrial fusion and fission is often referred to as mitochondrial dynamics. And it really depends on the balance between two key proteins, dynamin-related protein 1, also known as DRP1, and mitofusin 2, or MFN2 for short. As its name implies, MFN2 is involved with mitochondrial fusion. MFN2 is found on the outer mitochondrial membrane, and it works in tandem with this other protein, optic atrophy 1, found on the inner mitochondrial membrane. And together, these two proteins pull together the organelles until eventually the membranes fuse, forming these elongated structures of mitochondria, like we can see here in red using confocal microscopy. DRP1, on the other hand, works completely opposite of MFN2. DRP1 localizes to the outer membrane of these elongated structures, and it oligomerizes, forming this ring-like structure that constricts around the mitochondria, eventually breaking them apart into these fragmented or punctate mitochondria, like we can see here with the MitoTracker red dye under confocal microscopy. But to determine whether or not mitochondrial morphology was critical for these pancreatic cancer cells, what we first did was we genetically knocked out DRP1 using CRISPR. And what we found was these cells did form these elongated tubular structures, And after measuring oxidative metabolism using a seahorse mitostress assay, what we found was quite interesting. The ATP production not only decreased, but basal and spare respirations declined significantly. But what does this have to do with the tumors? Well, not only did knocking out DRP1 significantly decrease tumor burden, but it also, after orthotopically implanting them into mice, increased overall median survival by more than threefold. So to really understand whether or not fusion was the driving mechanism behind this decreased tumor burden and increased overall survival, what we then did was overexpressed MFN2 using a tetracycline-inducible system. And after inducing with doxycycline, what we found was, again, we saw that these cells had elongated structures of mitochondria. And after measuring oxidative phosphorylation, we again saw a similar result. ATP production significantly dropped, and basal respiration almost cut in half. So how did this affect the tumor cells by overexpressing MFN2? Well, once again, what we found was that after overexpressing MFN2, not only was tumor burden decreased, but after orthotopically implanting them into mice, we again saw this increase in overall survival by over 25%.
Hi, my name is Dr. Meifang Yu. I am the lead author of this paper. So as our data proposed, mitochondrial fission can be a perfect therapeutic target for pancreatic cancer treatment, as most normal cells have elongated mitochondria. Unfortunately, there's no available drug can target mitochondrial fission now. So recently, there's a paper showed the FDA-approved drug, leflunomide, can induce MFN2 expression and promote mitochondrial fusion. That sounds pretty interesting. So what is leflunomide? Here's some quick fact about leflunomide. It inhibits dehydroorotate, dehydrogenesis. It required for the de novo synthesis of pyrimidine. It used to treat rheumatoid arthritis. So to determine whether leflunomide has a similar activity in pancreatic cancer, we treat our KPC cells with the drug and observed a significant increase of MFN2 protein expression, along with increased mitofusion by mitochondrial staining. By using seahorse to measure mitochondrial respiration, we can see leflunomide significantly decreased basal respiration, spare respiration, and ATP production. So we further use leflunomide to treat pancreatic cancer in multiple models. The drug was delivered 5 days per week, and it was tolerated well, and we didn't see any major toxicity. So the survival was greatly enhanced in KPC flank tumor and KPC orthotopic tumor. So these survival benefits was further verified in the aggressive KPC spontaneous tumor. As we can see here, the leflunomide also showed single agent activity, and the median survival was increased by 50% from 22 days to 33 days, which is pretty amazing for this aggressive tumor model. Next, in order to understand how mitochondrial fusion decreased respiration, we detect mitochondrial mass. It makes sense if the cell have less mitochondria, it got lower respiration. So qPCR was used to amplify two different mitochondrial DNA, ND1 and ND2. We found decreased mitochondrial mass after DRP1 knockout. There are two possible ways to decrease mitochondrial mass, either through decreased mitochondrial biogenesis or through increased mitochondrial clearance. First, we'll take a look at the mitochondrial biogenesis. We measured the mRNA expression of PGC1 alpha, which is a major regulator of mitochondrial biogenesis. And we didn't see any big differences after DRP1 knockout or MFN2 expression. So since there's no change in mitochondrial biogenesis, we took another look at the mitochondrial clearance, also referred as mitophagy, to see whether decreased mitochondrial mass is related to mitochondrial clearance. immunofluorescence staining was used to measure mitophagy. So the red fluorescence is TOM20 labeled mitochondria. Green fluorescence is autophagy marker SE3. The yellow fluorescence is a co-localization of mitophagy and mitochondria. So after DRP1 knockout, we see increased mitophagy as we saw more co-localization. And the percentage of mitophagy in cells was increased by almost 3 times. So here's a quick summary. We start with the observation that pancreatic cancer have fragmented mitochondria. So through DRP1 knockout, MFN2 overexpression, and the leflunomide treatment to induce mitochondrial fission, which promoted mitophagy, increased mitophagy further decreased mitochondrial mass, decreased mitochondrial oxidase, and inhibit tumor growth.
So in this study, we demonstrated that leflunomide had very strong single agent activity against pancreatic cancer in a preclinical model. Because leflunomide is an FDA-approved drug for rheumatoid arthritis, the next step is to try to repurpose this drug in the treatment of pancreatic cancer, most likely in a combination with standard of care chemotherapy, such as gemcitabine and nab-paclitaxel, or the combination FOLFIRINOX. These are the next sets of experiments that we will do in trying to bring this therapy to the clinic.